Hi there, it's LaShawn. If you've just found my channel, welcome. And if you are returning, welcome back. Thank you for supporting me here on LaShawn's Lifestyle. I appreciate you so much. So today's video is my kinda late, but late budget wrap up for the month of September. So let's go ahead and see how my results were for that month. All right, so I'm already on my calendar dashboard layout. So the first thing I want to do is mark down my no spends. So really quickly, I'm just going to put NS. I'm going to start back with the no spend stickers that I like so much. In October, I had ran out. So I have them now, but I didn't want to have half of it written and then half of it with a sticker. So I'm just going to, for continuity, just keep it the way I had been doing it. So I had a no spend on the 15th. I had a no spend on the 16th. I had a no spend on the 17th. And I did spend on the 18th. I had a no spend on the 19th. A no spend on the 20th. Look at that, y'all. I am cooking with oil. Let's see. Let me get to the proper page in my notes. Okay, so then I didn't have my next no spend until the 22nd and the 23rd. Whoopsie. And y'all excuse my nails. I know they look atrocious. I'm gonna get them done. And then I had a no spend on the 25th. A no spend on the 26th. Three Saturdays in a row, y'all. Okay. I don't know what's going on here, but okay. All right. Then I had a no spend on the 28th, a no spend on the 29th, and a no spend on the 30th. All right. So let's see. So we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Wow. So we had 18 no spends for the month. That is super duper awesome. So, wow, I'm shocked. I don't know why though, because there's no place really to go to spend a whole lot of money. There's that. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and check off. I do know that all of my bills have come out of my account, or whatever transfers I needed to make have been completed. So I'm just gonna check those all off as paid. So we're good there. So let's go ahead and we're gonna turn to the goals section, the highlight page, so we can see how well I did with my goals for the month. Okay, so the three goals that I had set was to have 15 no spend days. I actually was three over, so this was a pass, so I actually had 18, which is great. Goal number two was to save $50 from my cash envelopes, and that's been my ongoing goal for a while now. So let's go ahead and turn to my savings tracker for the month of September, and I will link that closeout in the cards above so you can see how that actually panned out. But I just want to quickly look to see how much in the tracker that I was able to save. So I was able to save $98, so $48 over what my goal was. So again, another pass. So I'm just gonna write that I saved $98. That is so, so awesome. And if you don't know, the money that I save from my cash envelopes, I've been putting it in my pouch with a purpose is what I call it. So this is the money that I've been saving each month from my cash envelopes. And what I'm doing is I want to get a new light fixture. So you can see here that I just put a sticky note here that just says new light fixture in dining room and how much it is. And that's what I'm using this money for. So any money that I save from my cash envelopes will be going to into the pouch of purpose to buy certain things that I can, that I want to, you know, do around the house or do for myself or whatever, but mostly for doing around the house because I'm kind of in decor mode, but trying to do it in a save the money or come up with the money kind of, you know, like in a creative way so that I can cash front it or cash flow it, you know, without coming too much out of the budget. Or I can tell you right now, I do have a home decor sinking funds and I'm always using that. So yeah, there's that. All right, so goal number three then is to was to pay off my BPAS, which is a personal loan. The balance was at the time $701.16. So let's take a quick look at my debt tracker and see how that panned out. So here, BPS again was my creditor that I was attacking. That was my snowball item, and I started at 701.16. I did make the full payment of 701.16, so I owe nothing to them anymore. I paid that off, so I did meet this goal. So that is another pass, and yeah, I paid off that balance. So super duper hyped about that. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at the actual budget. Okay, so this is my actual budget for September, and I did do a mid-month check-in. I will link that in the cards above as well if you want to go back and look at the mid-month, but we're going to go ahead and start from where I left off. And as you saw in the calendar dashboard layout, I already checked off these items because I know they were paid. So I'm just going to do a quick check here that everything came out or was transferred properly. The debt snowball amount did go towards paying off BPAS. I put my money, I only did half of my sinking funds. My sinking funds are normally $300 for the month, but I needed that extra money to go to the debt snowball in order to pay off BPAS. So I only funded half of my sinking fund. And then of course my cash envelopes was $400 for the month, and again I only stuff my cash envelopes once a month and then I do a weekly check-in. So although I did save $98 from that, I'm not gonna put like $302 here because I'm still utilizing the entire $400, so that will stay as is. So I'm gonna go ahead and check these off. So with everything coming down and being the actual being what was budgeted or planned out, that left me a remaining of $51.47. $50 went to my savings, which I will be coming with a savings tracker. And what I will be tracking is actually my savings account, my stock account, investment account. And my investment account includes stocks and ETFs, so I will be doing that, and it also include and it will also include my 401k. So I had a left $1.47, which went into my Do What I Want account. So let's go ahead and take a look at that tracker that I use for that account. Okay, so I'm in the notes section of my planner, and this is where I track my miscellaneous fund account, or my Do What I Want account is what I call it. And so I ended, or I had, and this is a Capital One 360 account. It's just a regular checking account that I use it, have a ATM card for a debit card for it. So if I want to use anything, I can. But it's just, you know, a little, it's not a big balance. I don't keep a whole lot in there. I try to utilize as much money, much of my money as possible with things that I, you know, need to put those, allocate those funds to. So when it's small amounts or anything like that, I just throw it into this account. So I ended with a balance of $4.75. I did not use it, and let me switch that out so I have, because this is in purple. So I did not utilize it at all. And then $1.47 went to it, which was left over from my September's budget. So that puts me at, and I don't feel like doing head math, y'all, so we're gonna do this. 475 plus 147. So that puts me at a whopping $6.22. So the malls better watch out, because I'm kicking down the door to do some damage with that $6.22. All right, so let's go ahead and turn back to the budget. All right, everyone, so that is it in a nutshell. That is my budget and how it panned out, how I met my goals, which I'm super duper stoked and proud of myself. It does take some discipline to reach those goals, but I think once I get, you know, kind of get the ball rolling and doing what I'm supposed to do, it makes it a lot easier. So everything panned out. I ended with, of course, my zero-based budget. I was able to put money to my pouch with a purpose. I paid off a debt totally, and September was great. I'm not mad at it at all. So if you've lasted this long in this video, thank you so much. You are a lifestyler, and if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. Like, comment, and share. And also follow me on Instagram at LuShawn's Lifestyle. I truly would appreciate it. So until my next video, hugs and love. Bye.